In this video, we're going to discuss the idea of what is a home run cable and how do we connect that between our J-box and our indicator. So the home run cable is nothing more than a blunt end cable on both ends. This could be a 4-wire or a 6-wire cable. And this cable is used to connect our J-box up to our indicator. You can see I've got a 4-channel J-box here. I currently have 4 simulators hooked into this. And the color code for the load cells is a black for the negative X, a red for the positive X, white for the negative signal, and green for the positive signal. Now, there is no color code, however, for the home run cable. It's not the color that makes it function because it's blunt end on both sides. But I might recommend that we use the same color code so that we don't introduce confusion. So I want to make sure that I simply match up my negative X. So if I'm using black for negative X on the J-box side, I'm just going to use black for negative X on the indicator side. And again, that could be any color we want it to be. So if you don't happen to have a home run cable or, you know, a piece of blunt end cable that matches your load cell cable, that's okay. Just make sure everything is straight through. So when we go ahead and hook this up, because my load cells are using the black, red, green, white, I'm going to do the same thing. So with my positive X, we're using red, so we're going to go ahead and hook up that positive X. And on my J-box, you'll see there's 2 strips here. One is labeled EXP and one is labeled IND. So the EXP is for the expansion because I could take 2 4-channel J-boxes and daisy chain them together. The IND side is for indicator. So this is where we want to make sure that this is the cable that goes directly to the indicator where the expansion would go off to the next J-box if we were daisy chaining. All right, so we'll move to our black cable here for the minus X, and we'll put that one in there. And then we'll do our plus and minus signal. We'll use, we got green for the plus signal and white for the minus signal. So again, plus X, minus X is black, plus sig is green, minus sig is white. So I just want to make sure I do the same thing on the indicator side. So I got my 682 here, and this is going to need to wire into where we would hook in our load cell for the A to D. If I just had a single load cell, I'd put that right here. Here I'm just going to hook the J-box in. The J-box takes care of putting them all together. We just have to wire that J-box into that same location. And we're going to use the same configuration here, plus and minus X, black, red and black respectively, and the plus and minus signal, green and white. And so we'll just wire this up, make sure the connector matches. It's going to go this way. So the plus sig is on this end. Followed by the minus sig. And then we have our plus X there. And then our minus X there. Now that we have those into the connector, we can just go ahead and plug that in. And our simulator should now function on the scale. And that's how you wire up a home run cable from your J-box to your indicator.